all been pre-shuffled, but I'll just do one for the good measure. We're gonna start by getting some insight on where you're at currently, and then we're going to be asking the cards what's coming towards you. And then finally, we'll actually be getting some insight on the invisible influences at hand. All right, Virgo, which Virgos am I speaking to? We have a card flipping in the deck, but we're not going to put it in the spread. We're just going to take a look at it, though. So this is going in the spread. We have communication messages coming in. And I'll get a much bigger picture, of course, once we get all the cards on the table. So bear with me. I'll just be throwing out maybe a couple of descriptors as these cards fly out, but they all affect each other. So you really can't tell the whole story until they're out of the deck and they've chosen you. All right. Situation from Virgo. Okay. Situation from Virgo. Right on. All right, so I'm gonna get some insight on what's coming towards Virgo. August into September, we've got another flipping in the deck. That makes two. I'm just gonna make a note of them, that this is the Justice card with the Ace of Wands. Already there's, this reading is already very interesting. What's coming towards Virgo in August, September, all that. We have Four of Cups coming out with the Two of Swords. What's coming towards Virgo in the month of August? Please make a place for it. Swords. What's coming towards Virgo in the month of August? Please make a place for it. What's coming towards Virgo in the month of August? Thank you. All right. So, Virgo, currently, this is regarding the Virgos out there, that you are about to receive information or a message, or you have just received information or a message that is actually quite consequential in your future and in your present. And there might be kind of decisions to be made soon around that information coming up. I'm going to be getting clarity on some of this, but the Queen of Pentacles is definitely either you or somebody in the picture currently regarding this information, this message coming through. The Queen of Pentacles is somebody who's quite nurturing, also hardworking, good with their money, and can be quite generous with their money. They love with their money, not only with their money, but they can demonstrate generosity and love through it. They enjoy nice things usually, and they know how to work hard for that money. Oftentimes, for some of you, this could even literally represent the sign of the single mother, but not for all of you. But you get the idea. The Queen of Pentacles is a very versatile and nurturing energy. The Judgment card comes up in regards to this message coming in, or this communication you're having. And that's because there is kind of an awakening period, that it's a game changer, whatever this information is. We'll be getting more clarity on that, but I wanna move forward into what to expect coming into the rest of August, into September, possibly even as far as early October for some of you guys. There is an offer, it looks like. There's something on the table, and that is met with a little bit of apathy. Basically, somebody here is a little afraid to make a choice. The choice is not clear because intuition is a little bit, it's a little bit far away from you. It's funny, I'm looking for the word, and the word describes what I'm experiencing right now. But she can't see the moon. The moon represents intuition. Sorry for the glare. And she can't see that moon. She can't make a choice between two swords. She's blindfolded. And that is that inability to really see the choice at hand. Usually what causes that is fears, triggers, anxieties, sometimes a sense of being overwhelmed. And what the cards are saying regarding this is there's going to be a period of going inward with the Four of Swords, going inward instead of looking outward for any answers, which can be sometimes more confusing, going inward, meditating, thinking on it, and even doing maybe some strategizing. Then we have the Queen of Wands, which represents an energy that is very much extroverted, instinctual. It seems that you will then know what movements and what things to do and create around this. And then we have the Star card, which is a healing card. It's a get your wish card. It's very positive. It also can sometimes mean that you're being very much noticed, getting attention. So we're gonna get a little bit more of an idea here. And then we'll go into the part of the spread that talks about the hidden influences in the situation, which can be quite helpful. I'd like to know more information about, currently I feel like Virgo's balance is at hand regarding this information. I'd like to get a card for the Page of Swords. Tell us about this information, this message currently for Virgo. Message currently for Virgo, please. Helpful message currently for Virgo. Yes, whatever this is, I think it does kind of trigger a little bit of the subconscious, the shadow sides. It's almost like a sense of something hidden being brought to light. And the Moon card is oftentimes very representative of that, right? Just being the moon, it's the things that go bump in the night. And so that's why it represents all things subconscious and in the dream world. I'd like to know more about this awakening, this kind of game changer energy with a Judgment card around this information, this message. Thank you so much. Okay, we've got the Fool card flying out with the Seven of Pentacles. So this almost feels a little bit like a fork in the road, not necessarily a completely unrelated road to what you've been working on, but there is, with Seven of Pentacles, it's kind of taking a break, looking at everything you've worked on and knowing that there's quite a bit of work stretching out before you, but taking it all in. And even when you're exhausted, still kind of like, it's that pause to reevaluate everything. And there is a reevaluating going on. The Fool suggests that there is this opening, this new opportunity to start a very brand new journey within this. Does that make any sense? So I think that you're looking at your ability to, I feel that for most of you, the Queen of Pentacles energy, this very nurturing but hardworking energy, is you. And so it's kind of like a lot of you guys are going to be asking, can I provide? Will I make enough to provide with this? It does feel like a balance between time and efforts, like work, time and work, managing that. So this Four of Cups coming at you is an offer that you're not... It's not like you're meeting the offer with a ton of excitement, just because it throws you into a place of indecision. All right, so let's find out a little bit more about this offer, because I'm kind of curious why the indecision. So we'll get some insight on both. Okay, so the offer for Virgo. Thank you. You know, this is, the world opens up with this offer, and that's somewhat uncomfortable for Virgo sometimes. Virgos are so, they're very good at the slow and steady, and that slow and steady wins the race. And this does trigger that and challenge that, just because it is like, I feel this energy of like, whoa, 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 wait a minute. What? Let me think about this. You know, the world is opening up. And you have the skill set for this, very much so. So that's the offer, is definitely throwing you into that fool's journey of something new. Anything else about this offer that we can get for Virgo? Anything about this offer for Virgo? It definitely feels, I gotta say, it's funny because it's a relationship reading, but I'm not getting a really super lovey-dovey vibe from this. I'm getting kind of more a feeling of strategic energy of like making life plans for Virgo. Hermit. Yeah, you know, there's no way but to go forward except for inward. The way forward is inward with this, with the Virgo energy of the Hermit. That's what you know best, and that's what you do best, regardless of what you choose. You have to, it's about the journey for you and how you make that choice. It's very important. Okay, I want Two of Swords. Please insight on the Two of Swords. All right, so we have double cards right side by side from two different decks. We have the Two of Pentacles here, and we have the Two of Pentacles here. So yeah, definitely the choice is a little overwhelming. You're very concerned about life balance. How does this throw your life out of balance, and how can you adjust? And what does adjusting for this look like, okay? Yeah. I'd like some insight on the Queen of Wands, please. Who's this Queen of Wands for Virgo? Flipping in the deck is the World card, which is communication sometimes from a distance and also an end of a state phase. All right, Virgo. Well, I feel like the deck's having a little bit of fun with us because we have the same card here and the same card here as well. I feel very much like Queen of Pentacles. It really represents most of you, like I was saying earlier. This looks like Queen of Pentacles along with comes out in connection with Queen of Wands. This is another individual. Queen of Wands is somebody who is ruled by their instincts. They're quite extroverted. They're very much liked and noticed if they want to be. When they're in balance and they're healthy, they're very much kind of the mover and shaker, and they can be like the hostess with the mostess and be influential and positive. And when they're out of balance, they can be kind of scary and manipulative. But I don't know why I wanted to tell you that, but this is somebody who's, I think, either making the offer or this is either way a partner. This is somebody that's in the picture for some reason. They are different from you. They shoot from the hip a little bit. You go inwards and strategize and think about your decisions carefully before you actually say them or make them. And I think I'm feeling very compelled to mention say. So I think this person is somebody who says things a little bit quicker than they think about it. Like you think about things before you say them, and they kind of, they say them before they think about them. Sometimes that means they put their foot in their mouth, but this is also something that you're taking into consideration because it's as confident as they work through life. It is kind of a vulnerable point, and it's one of those places where you more is revealed than they realize, you know? So that's kind of your strength and it's their weakness, if that makes any sense. All right, so the Star card coming out. Why is the Star card coming out? All right. This is something that, for some reason, you're getting the Ten of Wands, which is like wrapping up something exhausting, okay? It's coming to it. The light is at the end of the tunnel. excuse me. Four of Wands has something to do with security, structure, sometimes gatherings like weddings, but it can very much ties to marriage. There we go, the Star card. I just wanted to pop out. It just felt right. I don't normally do this, but I'm gonna take it. All right. This is communications, a fresh message regarding like a complicated situation where there was disagreement or competition. This could even be a custody battle. This could be, I want some clarity. I feel like it's more like, I feel that others have been involved here and you're being seen. You're very much kind of being noticed in this situation, and you're carrying these wands and finishing up this exhausting project. It's really having an effect on your sense of security, like home security. Information comes through, and kind of insight about there's a sense of competition and possibly arguing here, but in the end, it's like it's the whole thing. Even though it's been kind of exhausting, is healing and strengthening, which is a very, very positive thing. This is a really unique reading. I'm gonna actually get up and get a whole nother deck because we've used so many from those two. So please bear with me. I don't normally do this, but this is the other deck that did call to me today in regards to your reading. I'm gonna give it a shuffle, and then we're gonna be asking what invisible influence are affecting you right now. So it looks like, Virgo, before I go forward, I want to mention, just in to wrap this up and we can get more clarity, excuse me, it looks like, generally speaking, right now you are in communications, like it's about the communication of this possible offer, what's going to turn into a possibility or an offer, a decision to be made in the rest of the month and coming up in September. And currently, you're going to be a little bit, you know, this information is going to dredge up some things that maybe possibilities or thoughts that haven't occurred to you for a little while or ever. And it might be a little bit overwhelming because you do sense that there's a shift coming up, and there indeed is. You're having a pause, you're looking at like everything that you've worked on, and you're kind of at that fork of the road of like, do I want to continue this work, whatever you're putting this effort into, which could be a relationship, which almost, it very much feels like it ties into the way that your life is formatted, if that makes any sense, because there is this possibility of the Fool's Journey, of starting this brand new thing, and it all stems from this communication. You're being reminded of kind of your nurturing energy and the balance around that, making money versus and how you give it out, and that balance between like intake and outtake. So coming up soon, you know, you've got this decision that kind of overwhelms you, and inward is the way forward. That is really, or I can even say the other way, I like the sound of it, going forward, you know, the way the way to go forward is going inward, I'll say it that way. There is this other individual that the cards are bringing our attention to, which who's a bit different to you, than you. They're very outward, extroverted. They make their decisions quicker. They run by their instincts and sometimes have the tendency to put their foot in the mouth because they speak before they think. And that's your strength, not necessarily theirs. But there is a sense of wrapping up the energy here, wrapping up a project. It's going to have positive effects eventually on your sense of security and even be somewhat healing. And yeah, this feels like you come out very much stronger, which feels really good. I want insight on the hidden influences so that, you know, when Virgo is kind of going inward, what they can kind of consider. So this is food for thought. Thank you. Thank you. All right. We have pretty powerful cards here. There's the Magician coming out with the Nine of Pentacles. That is the Independence card, along with a big Manifestor card. We again have a lot of doubles. This is four of Swords, same card. And this is our third deck, right? This is why we get fresh decks, because it gives the cards the opportunity to really drive home a message here. All right, so there was at one point, let's see, you have manifested a sense of independence. And inside that independence, you've evolved as the Queen of Pentacles. The other side of you has gotten stronger, which is the Pentacle side, the ability to create financial security for you and those who you love. And you did that on your own. You are still wanting to continue that manifesting of your own independence. And that's why you're going inward with the Four of Swords here and the Four of Swords here. And it's becoming clear now that this offer and this information coming forward, you don't want to sacrifice anything that you've put the hard work into manifesting, contributing to your sense of independence, because you've actually been quite successful in evolving into a character that you quite like. And you've learned that you actually can really, not only are you a powerful manifester, but you can actually, you have the imagination. It's almost this sense of like, if I can imagine it, I really have discovered that I can do it. You've really become stronger through a process that you've been going through. And you don't want to sacrifice that. And that's very understandable. So it looks like really going forward around this sense of balance, this needing to balance, the balance is between what you've manifested, this independent character and the ability to work hard and make your own independence, and this offer and this information coming in. I would say that it keeps on coming back to that message of the way forward is inward, my dears. And you are going to allow yourself to take a moment, meditate, go on walks. If there's a park nearby, if it's swimming laps at a pool, wherever you're drawn inward, like I can feel it in my energy. And you're going to probably be somewhat surprised at the clarity around your feelings, and the way forward will become much clearer that way. All right, I will see you very soon. I'll be doing your September readings just in the next week. So I love you very much. Please hit the like and subscribe button. I will talk to you soon. Bye.